Hey, Java developers, and in this case, operation folks managing JVMs as well. JDK Mission Control 9 is here. Let's take a look at some of the key changes in this release of JMC. The most significant change with this release is the requirement of JDK 17 to run JMC. However, an important note here, while JDK 17 is required to run JMC, it can still read JFR recordings from JDK 7 U40 or later, as seen in this example of reading a JFR recording from a simple Java application running on JDK 7. JMC now uses Eclipse 4.30, which is part of the Eclipse 2023-12 project, which includes many changes itself. Check this link in the description for details. There is now support for a dark mode in JMC. You can now configure how often the JVM browser will check for new JVMs. The default matches the previous hard-coded value of 5,000 milliseconds. The JMC JFR parser now supports checkpoint event sizes beyond the U4 limit. You can now search for events in the event type browser by event type ID. Event type ID can also be displayed, but by default, it is hidden. For Graal VM users, JMC can now enable JFR or native images. Previously, this was not possible if the native image had JFR support. The flame graph visualization has been updated to be rendered using Java Swing. Previously, this graph was rendered using an embedded browser. The switch to using Java Swing improves the model creation and performance. JMC has a rules engine that performs automated analysis of an application for potential performance bottlenecks. A few rules have been added with this release, including a rule if G1 pause times are above target, a rule that looks for finalization statistics. This is in response to finalization being deprecated for removal in JDK 18, and a rule that detects GC inverted parallelism. GC inverted parallelism is a way of determining if a GC that uses multiple threads for handling GC work is using those threads efficiently. For more on this, check this JBS ticket, link in the description. These are only some of the high-level changes included in JMC 9. In total, nearly 200 tickets are a part of this release. For more on these changes, I recommend checking out Marcus Hertz's blog article on JMC 9 or the JDK Buds system for the full list of changes. Links for both in the description and this video's accompanying article. Happy coding!